just making sure it's all working. Hello, people. Yes, it's Deer Poo Park. Sunday, the Sunday, the whatever it is, I'll lose track of days. Up here, yes, with the spit. I still haven't cut the grass, well, I haven't cut the reeds or weeds, whatever you want to call them. Landing, this is like, as I said before, like landing a real plane in a bamboo field. Now, my video yesterday was 99.9% accurate. I did mention the name of the company quite a few times. FMT, and I did mention that quite a few times. This is a clue, because the real story is even more fantastic than my slightly fictitious story. FMT, well, what can I say? FMT stands for my old buddy, Flanker Martin Tanker, FMT. Admittedly, it's not Scale Models Limited, but it is FMT. I'll give it the backstory to it now, which I find even more amazing than my cock and bull story at the beginning. Martin bought this little spit a few months ago, with all good intention of flying it. Then Hobby King brought out the 1. Whatever meter Spitfire, the real deal, retracts, split flaps, the full Monty. And looking at them both, he thinks, I'm not really going to fly the E-Sheen, not after I've got the 1. Whatever meter real deal spit. He knows how enamoured I was with my T28, and I coined the phrase the smile machine. And he decided to gift it to me, which I thought was even more astounding than the story I first put out about the model company. So the T28, I love it. Great, it is a small machine. I'm nowhere near as serious a flyer as Martin, so he knows I sort of quite enjoy flying these things. And that is the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so it'll be good. It was indeed Flanker Tanker, alias Martin, FMT, is actually gifted me this plane that he bought, great intentions of flying, but decided not to. Thank you so much. This is what I consider the internet as a whole to be about. Like-minded people get together, swapping ideas, tips, tricks, etc., etc., etc. Never in my wildest dreams did I think that somebody give me a kite, let alone a spit. Martin, thank you so much, mate. You're an absolute buddy. Thank you so much. Right, I shall endeavour to start it up. Right, now it's quite windy up here today, more windy than I would have liked, I must admit. It's blowing from the east, which is quite a cool wind, which is rather nice, but it's blowing at about 8 mph plus, so we'll We'll have to wait and see. See what happens. Yep, that's all initialized rather well. Just wonder whether this is going to be a bit too windy up here. If it is, I'll just do one short flight and that'll be it. Don't really want to risk it for a biscuit, as they say. Right, let's Right. Even more nervous than usual on a maiden, because this has been gifted to me. It's quite windy, to say the least. Quite windy, to say the least. No, well, obviously the old underarm tactic isn't working. I think this is going to be too windy today. Oh, fella. Yeah. A little bit gusty up there today. Thank you. Great little planes these are. I consider not being everybody's cup of tea, but I still think they're a small machine. Thank you so much, Martin. I cannot still stop saying thank you. Little bit windier than I'd like today. And so it is sort of gusting between 8 and perhaps 10. And yes, if you want to know, I've got it on beginner mode. There's no way that I want to risk it on a maiden doing silly buggers. Although, I might bring it down and see if I can do a vertical climb. Yes. Yes, yes, look at that. See, Junior, you can do a vertical climb. I think you tried it once before. I don't know whether you've bottled out or not, but the T28 certainly does it. And I thought, yeah, I must admit, I did take it out of beginner mode then and put it into medium, as they call it, intermediate mode. This is the absolute business. Martin, if you have half as much fun with your Hobby King spit, then I'll be well pleased for you, mate. Extremely well pleased for you. So I've done a little bit of kiting there. Downwind, this thing goes like an absolute rocket. I mean, that, I'm just kiting. Then, and that is flight behind myself. Rule number one. But the wind took it, one of those things. This is an absolute little speed machine. Love it. I'm going to bring it in because I don't want to cane the batteries on this, unlike my Zod that I'll take down to 1%. So I can cook a rasher of bacon on it. I'm going to go quite gentle in these batteries. You got to watch it on this one. Unlike the T28, you can cut the power and just kite it. But this one does drop a wing. Whether that's going to transfer to your one, Martin, on the Hobby King Spitfire, you gotta watch it because they can drop a wing. Right, time to bring the baby in. Happy with that. Defo happy with that. Extremely happy with that. I'm not going to do any more flights today. Simple reason it is, just too windy. Just is. So it's only a little kite that does they get blown about quite a bit. There's a guy up there now flying high wing, not sure what it is. But it's about 1.1, 1.2 meter kite. That's the size you want today. But you know what, Martin? I'm gonna say it one more time, mate. Thank you so much. Blown away, absolutely blown away. As I said, I'm more blown away than that cockerel story. Well, it wasn't a cockerel story. It was a slightly embellished story, but the real story is even better. Thank you so much, my old buddy.